Hey guys! Thanks for watching Tours by Kenzo! This is the third video of Japanese Garden series. Japanese gardens can be classified into three different types, followed by dry garden and moss garden. Today I'll talk about pond garden. Pond gardens are probably the most popular type for those coming from abroad. I understand why. Pond gardens are really special because making a pond garden requires a lot of money, big space, care and labor for maintenance. So only the rulers of Japan who were rich and powerful enough were able to make pond gardens. The creation of major pond gardens started about 1,000 years ago. Back then, the owners were Buddhist temples sponsored by the emperors of Japan and powerful aristocratic families. The idea of making a pond garden was to create Buddhist heaven. By looking at a pond garden, sponsors hope to reborn in the world of Buddha. As the time passed, samurai and shogun gained more power, and they made huge pond gardens by their castles. The theme was to create miniature Japan. They planted different types of trees on various terrains, so the visitors would feel as if they were looking at mountains and ocean. They also used several beautiful big rocks that were super expensive, and brought a lot of water to the garden. Water was very difficult to control back in those days. By controlling labor and environment, they showed off their power. The same example is the Palace of Versailles in France. When samurai and the shogun gave up their power and Japan was open to the world in the 19th century, the new government took an initiative to modernize the country. The politicians worked really hard to catch up to the Western countries, so did the businessmen. Those who gained fortune owned pond gardens afterwards. That's why modern pond gardens have fewer religious aspects and controlling nature concepts. Instead, the owners wanted more relaxation and a place for business and political negotiation. The purpose of owning a pond garden has changed over the period of time. Alright, so let me wrap up by telling you the meaning of each element which create a pond garden. First, water. Water represents the ocean. And it also means a border between this world and spiritual world. Second, rocks. Rocks placed in the pond represent holy islands for gods and Buddhas. Next, bridges. Bridges connect this world and spiritual world, so people could travel to the spiritual world after dying. That's why the shape looks like a rainbow. Beautiful koi carps are the symbols of success. This idea came from a legend that koi can jump up a waterfall to become a dragon. A dragon is an auspicious creature in the Eastern world. So, a waterfall is often made in a koi pond too. In summer, the sound of a waterfall cools off the heat. It also gives us the impression of a deep mountain. Evergreen trees symbolize eternal prosperity, and deciduous trees symbolize changing season and impermanence. Balance is important. Lanterns. You can put a candle inside. The flame navigates good spirits and keeps evil spirits away. Wash basins. They symbolize purification and we can sometimes use the basins to wash our hands. Pond gardens have a lot to explain. If you have some questions, please leave me a comment. I'd love to answer them. Thanks for watching and see you in my next video.